Well, good morning, Strawberry. Morning, Ethan. How we doing, buddy? You like to be petted, don't you? Hmm. Your water's good. Your water is good. And you got plenty of food. We'll get you guys some chicken scratch. Well, good morning. Are you looking for some chicken scratch? Get you open here. There's some. There you go. The other girl, is she laying on the eggs? Must be. You still sitting on them eggs? No chickens yet? Well, good morning. Bunch of chickens. Want some scratch? Scratch. Good morning. How we doing? One more week, we're going to move you outside. Yep, today I'm going to build your chicken tractor. Good morning, my friends. I'm Matt. Welcome to Richmond's Place Homestead. Glad to have you here. Today we're going to be working on our chicken tractor. For those of you who don't know what a chicken tractor is, a chicken tractor is a mobile device that keeps the chickens safe, secure, allows us to move them once a day or more if we want, and it will give the chickens fresh ground to forage from, bugs, worms, grass, in addition to the food that we're going to feed them. For those of you who don't know it, approximately 2 weeks ago, we got 20 meat birds. And next week, they will be going out to pasture. Actually, they'll be going out into the garden area because we have that additional security of the fencing. So let's get started. Today, we're going to be building the chicken tractor. It's going to be 5 foot by 8 foot, and it's going to be 2 feet tall. And the reason being is our mesh, which is a 24-inch mesh, 24 inches high, which will be plenty high enough for the chickens. And I got rolls in 5 foot long, and rows that are 10 foot long. So therefore, we're going to have a 5 foot by 8 foot. And the reason we're doing 8 foot instead of 10 foot is 2x2s that I have are 8 foot long. So I'm just trying to reduce the amount of work I'm going to have to do. We'll probably build two of these for the 20 chickens. By the way, guys, I'm the only guy I know that can have a dozen different tape measures and spend 3 hours looking for one. It's just my luck. All right, now that we've got the short boards cut at 5 foot, because I don't want any long or wider than 5 foot, now it's time to start putting it together with the 8 foot boards. The reason we choose 2x2s is because they're light. It'll make the chicken tractor light and easy to move. The downfall of those is they split real easy. So to counteract that, we're gonna pilot drill the holes and then put the screws in. This will help prevent the splitting. Then once we've drilled the pilot holes, we could put a screw in. Thank you. just got to be careful that you don't over torque them and it won't split on you. Alright, this lumber is not the straightest lumber, but it's going to work for the purposes that we're using it for. So it doesn't have to be perfect, it doesn't have to be pretty, it just has to be functional for the chickens. We're going to do this three more times, and I'll show you why we're doing it three times. Now here we are cutting our uprights. We are cutting these are 2x2s, and we are cutting them at 21 3/8 inches long. This will give us plenty of room to put our 24-inch wide hardware cloth without it going over the edges, because if we take our top and bottom and we add it to the 21 3/8, that gives us approximately 24 1/8, so there's just enough overhang that the hardware cloth won't be going beyond that. Now here we're now putting the bottom and the top together. Rebecca was very kind enough to come over
and hold things together while I am drilling the pilot holes and adding the screws. This part really took two people to do it. And so we'll be putting the bottom and the top together here.
All right. So we've got our bracing in. I did one side just as a test because, you know, how those things go. I want to make sure it comes out right when we're teaching you how to do this. So I'm going to show you where we're at with the bracing. The reason we use bracing is because we use these 2x2s and it's pretty light duty. So we wanted to make sure that the structure was sound. Yet, it's lightweight and it will be easy to handle and still be strong. So let's get the, let's start putting the hardware cloth on. And I want to tell you something, the hardware cloth, way better than chicken wire, goes on easier. It's a little more expensive, but nothing's gonna get in it. And putting it on is way, way better. All right, so we want to get our cloth started at one end and just work our way down. Now once we've got that one end secured, we're gonna roll it down and make sure that everything aligns, and then we can just finish stapling it down. And we just work our way down. Ruh-roh. And we're out of staples. So we're out of staples, which will conclude my night. I've got to go to the hardware store in the morning. Actually, we won't start this back up till Monday morning. Going up to Gaylord to say hi to my father. Happy Father's Day, so I'm going up there. It's a surprise. So I'm looking forward to that. And then Monday we'll get back on this. We'll get it finished up. Thank you for coming and enjoying this video with me. I really enjoy doing these. So again, what is a chicken tractor? Chicken tractor is a mobile device to move your meat chickens in from one spot to another on a daily basis. This gives them extra foraging, worms and bugs to eat, and they enjoy it that much more. And then also protects from predators, keeps them out of the weather, out of the elements. So we'll enjoy this. This is our first time with meat chickens. We're going to try it, and we want you to come on our journey with us, and we look forward to having you. This is going to be a lot of fun. In fact, this has been a lot of fun. I enjoy building little things like this. I am not a carpenter. Don't know nothing about it. But when I was a kid, I used to build a lot of forts. Yeah. Helped Dad out a lot. That helped. I learned some, maybe. Welcome back, everybody, for part two of the chicken tractor build. Glad to have you back. We're going to finish this out today. Where we left off, we ran out of staples when we were putting the hardware cloth on this side here. So we're going to finish that up, and then we're going to put hardware cloth on the end caps, and then we'll put the top on and begin to sheet metal that in. So stay with me. We're going to get this done. Hopefully you'll learn something, pick something up from this. Because if you're getting into homesteading, you got to have chickens, you know. And chickens are a lot of fun, especially when they're putting food on your plate. Yeah, we'll do something with that. Okay. Again, we'll start at the top. And we'll work our way down. The staples that I'm using, they're just half inch T50 staples. Just like that, we've already got the end covered, we got the sides covered, we're going to cover the other side, and then we're going to flip it back down and we'll start putting the top on. Okay, we've finished up the stapling. We now have the hardware cloth on four sides. This hardware cloth, it should keep anything out. It should keep out the snakes, the mice, the raccoons. They won't be able to get their claws through there. And that's the downfall of chickenware, or not groundhogs, but raccoons. Raccoons will reach through the chicken wire and get to your chickens that way. So the hardware cloth, way better to go. And let's talk about, well, let me lay this down and we're going to talk about the bracing. Let's see. Now this is extremely lightweight. It's heavy enough that predators won't be able to lift it up, but light enough for us to move it around without wheels. I looked at the ones that a lot of people had done online and I said, man, I don't want to have to put wheels on it. I don't want to have to, you know, don't want to struggle having to pull it. So we're going to, hopefully this is going to work. We've made it light. Lightweight, easy to handle. We put the bracing in so that we gave it the strength that it required. Now, on every leg, there are three braces, top, bottom. This way we can keep it lightweight. We didn't use any 2x4s. And if this one works out, we're gonna build another one exactly like it. Let's put the top on. With the top, we're gonna have to do exactly like we did with this here. We're gonna have to put some bracing in with it to give some strength before we put the sheet metal on. Thank you. Yeah, at this point, I'm going to make some bracing. I'm going to start cutting it. I take it in straight pieces, putting a 45 degree angle cut on each brace piece. That will ensure us that we'll have a nice square frame when we're done. So we set the cutter up, so it'll be cutting at a 45 degree angle. We're also going to cut some cross pieces to go across here. In here. And thereabouts. Just to give the sheet metal something solid to sit against. Seven, three, eight. All right. Now that we have those cut, we'll start drilling and screwing. Now the trick to this is you get this flat on here and you slide it right up to the next board. That way you know where you need to drill your hole, or you can start drilling it. Again, I'm going to slide this up. We're going to slide this up so that this here stays flat along this edge, and then we'll match up the, and then we'll push this into place where it needs to be to get it nice and square. And that is how we're putting the bracing on. Makes life going a little bit easier. This is going to make it really super strong. And I'm going to be very happy. Won't fall apart on us. At least I hope. That's the intention. To have something lightweight but strong. Okay, we got the supports in now. I'll give you a shot of that, and then we're gonna put the hinges on next. Now when putting these hinges on, they flap like this, so when it opens up wide, you'll be able to. So when we set the hinges, we'll put them on there like so, and then we'll drill them in, which we'll do right now. Thank you. There. Now we're going to screw the top on. Right back, line it up. Now that everything is even across, we can start screwing these in. Moment of truth, it should open up. Wow. That up there. By golly, I think we're ready to start putting the sheet metal on, putting the finishing touches on it, and it'll be done. Chicks will be going in here tomorrow. Thank you. screws that we're going to be using, they got a washer on them. They're a self-tapping screw. Missing a drill bit for it. Oh, I'm recording myself. That's a good thing. All right. Thank you.
Nice.
Put a handle on the front. It's very nice. Put a handle on the front of it. What do you think so far? It's looking good. It went almost exactly as planned. So now we gotta cut the I'm not sure if we're gonna put sheet metal on the sides or not. Good afternoon, everybody. This is day three. We're gonna finish this up. We just have to put a couple of eye bolts in here and attach rope to it so we could pull it around. Okay.
Look at her.
Rope hooked up. The idea is on a chicken tractor, you have the chickens in there and we're going to move it. And hopefully easily. And we opened it up so we could see that we're not going to be running over the chickens when we put them in here. And it'll keep them protected. Then once we move them, we put the food, the waters back in, and close the lid, and we're good till the next day. Well, until we got to feed and water them again. They eat a lot of food and water. They go through it. I can't believe how much they eat. We had to start taking their food away from them at night because they just gorge themselves to death. But I guess that's the way meat birds are. All right. Gonna move. These birds here, which have now outgrown this container, and boy do they stink, they're moving out to the chicken tractor. Rebecca's got to load them up and introduce them to their new home. They heavy? Hold on a second, honey. You're sideways. Turn your stick around the other way, though. No, get it upside down.
Okay.
Yep. Yep, just like that. That's good. As long as it's on the wood.
Maybe I should put it over here.
You're fine. They don't know what to think. This is their first time on fresh grass. Is that all of them?
Yep.
Yeah, just get their food and their water. Okay, for everybody who doesn't know what a chicken tractor is, this is the mobile device that we just built, and we can pull it with some little bit of effort. I don't want to move it right now because I got the water and feeders in there, but it's okay. This keeps them. This will keep them protected. It allows us to move them every day. We'll move them from that spot to right here tomorrow. And I'm hoping nothing can get to these chickens. Now, some could dig under it. Hopefully they won't. Thank you. I seem to be liking her newfound freedom. Fairly easy to open and close. It's fairly easy to open and close. It's light enough that even Rebecca could pull it. We don't have to have any wheels with it. We constructed everything out of 2x2s and hardware cloth and some sheet metal, so this will keep them safe. We can move them around and gives them a place to grow up in. Now the only thing I'm not sure about is what are we going to do when it rains. Rebecca just wants to throw a tarp over one end and let that be that. If I have to, we're going to try this out and see how it works. If we have to, we could put some channel on one side, maybe partway up on the other two sides with some wiggle wire, and then we'll be able to case part of it in plastic. We'll see how that goes though. And thank you for joining us through this build here in the tutorial. I hope you get a lot out of it. If you get any questions, leave them in the comment section. I hope you have a blessed day today. I hope you have a better day tomorrow. And I look forward to seeing you next time.